Hey folks, Quillytine here, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Hearts of Iron 4 as Japan's, the game that started as a live stream, but is continuing offline finally so that we can finish things up. It was a game that started pre-release to Hearts of Iron 4, which means all of my setups are just terrible. We don't have any tanks, you know, our divisions are set up dumbly. We don't have frickin' logistics companies or field hospitals, which I find extraordinarily painful. But we're not going to let that stop us. Let's go ahead and declare war on the USSR. We'll call in allies. And this should, I suspect, merge us in. I don't know. We'll see. I think everything's good. So there's not a lot of defenses on the Soviet front. We need to open this up because right now, Germany and Italy, they're being trounced pretty heavily and having a hard time. And people are pushing in from the west over here. So we'll go ahead and open up another front against the Soviet Union. We have opened up another front against the United States and Canada. In fact, a lot of the troops that are showing up here, these American troops, probably had to be recalled from Europe, which is really good for that front. Even if our progress stalls here, because we actually don't have that many troops in place, it's still probably going to be helpful. I do want to keep working on our doctrines, even though our base technology is doing pretty badly as well. Right, we have the People's Republic of China over here happening as well. So you guys, we do have a battle plan to take you on, so that'll hopefully be okay. Do you guys have a battle plan from the back? I actually don't know. Could you try to do a little bit of that and a little bit of that? All right, good. I mean, we are attacking into mountains pretty heavily here, which isn't very appealing. But we should have a fair deal more oomph. Also, across a river here. Yeah, that makes that very difficult. I also don't know if we have any planes operating in this area. Is this plane mode? Yeah. So really, over here, for example, we're going to grab a bunch of just fighters. It's okay. Even if they're fighter level ones. And try to get some air superiority over here. It's going to help out a lot. All right. Meanwhile, over here, my troops are not appearing to be advancing or doing anything. Oh, maybe we have already advanced a little. It's possible. I don't suppose, say, you just beeline for over there. Cut off supplies, isolate those guys. If you happen to get cut off, it's not the end of the world. You're just a single garrison unit. We could do a lot worse. So we didn't push through there. We're pushing through here, and we are going to take Portland. We're actively moving in that direction. We're also going to get another naval base, which again is going to help out with supplies because we've had a hard time. Expeditionary forces, that's fine. How's our army? Do we have anyone who's not in an army? Yes, we do. All y'all, since I'm thinking the Russian front is going to be heavily supply limited, I'm going to send a lot more people over here. And I don't suppose you can be a field marshal, could you? Do we have a decent field marshal? We do not. I'm going to promote this guy. It's okay to be a field marshal. He's bald, makes me think of Patrick Stewart. Well, not really, but let's pretend. Bald people are superior strategists or something. Moved forward there, hopefully don't lose that. You guys are all scooching. Just movement is extraordinarily slow, even here. Well, let's grab you and actually finish this little land grab here. So that's all being taken care of. Actually, this guy's still advancing to there, just to say. It's not the most important, but it's still going to be nice. Convoy escorts. All right, I'm going to swing away from our naval doctrine for a little while and grab. I'm going to grab night vision because, you know, that's, what is it, like 8 hours out of the cycle is night? And I don't think it varies by season. I think the night time is exactly the same all the time. Still, 10% stronger one third of the time. Ain't a bad extra little bonus. And we'll have to reorganize our attack lines relatively soon. You're moving in there, which is going to be great. You're holding that. And you can actually cut these guys off, which is going to be nice. I mean, just taking Spokane can be helpful. but if we get a bit of a surround, and obviously that will mean probably losing it afterwards, because someone else may come in. But in any case, we've cut this guy off, which is going to be brilliant and great. Okay, we have group purple here. I'm going to change you up. There. Also, group purple, your attack line is kind of the suck. Just push out something like that. Okay. And teal is mostly waiting for a lot of reinforcements to show up. We probably want to expand the naval base here. Get a few more levels as quickly as possible. Here in Oregon. And Washington State. Actually, the infrastructure is pretty good here. At a 6? That's very tolerable. Oh, I'm going to get you to stop. Don't attack there. Just try to hold Spokane, and that'll be good enough. So we're trying to very quickly get some troops over here, and hopefully hold that line. Portland's ours. Supply could be better over here, but isn't the worst. And we are attacking over here, and we probably should not be. I don't know. Could happen. If this guy gets cut off, it's not so bad, because he does have some reinforcements here. I mean, he'll still get surrounded, but other than that, we're doing okay. Oh, purple, you should get... Which one of these? What? Oh, there you go. Because we just advanced. Which, is it just me, or does the highlighting keep changing? Pause. Yeah, it does, because every time I highlighted, it was turning green. I just want to trim purple back over here. There we go. That's something like that. All right, how's the Soviet war? Oh, we've got actual naval battle going on here. Killing some American subs. Good. And you, Group Gold. You have a battle plan. I don't know why you're not moving forward. Into Soviet territory. Let's go. Chop, chop. And Group Blue over here, you actually don't have an offensive line. So I'm going to do that. And tell you guys you can be aggressive, which might be what's running out there. We've got... Oh, yeah, that's my defensive coastal stuff. That's okay. That is Portuguese. This is what? Vichy France? Which is in the Axis. Alright, good. We can keep ignoring that. We might be able to trim back some of these numbers here. It has been a while since we've been attacked. But, you know, maybe they're just trying to lull me into a false sense of security. Could happen. You guys. Okay, moving up there. Alright. And these guys have been nicely isolated. And I'm going to go ahead and make sure that we push in here. I mean, we could wait for them to get it more attritioned. But I think we're going to be okay, and then that'll thin out that front completely. But that's a good cutoff. You, go and do that. It was a very good cutoff. People are still working their way across the Pacific. Holding there, which is good. Moving forward a little bit in a couple places. Spokane's still there. Hopefully advancing this way. And advancing throughout the north over here. And yeah, you guys are ferrying down over there, which is going to be great. Okay. 1,000 airplanes there. So we've got a good amount of air. Let's take a look at the air zone. We have 100% air superiority in both air zones. Really good for our battles, plus a little bit of combat air support. Are you helping out? Could you maybe? That would be lovely. There we are. And it means we don't get the cutoff there, but it's a very safe advance. I should probably look for more encirclements, but... Alright, group purple here. I'm going to remove your actual offensive line over here. Yes, no, maybe? Oh, there it is. That was very annoying to try to click. So we still have some assigned to that front, but that'll be it. I'm going to send me one troop. Well, that's excellent. Now, is this all one big province? It is, good. Good, all of it, even all the little islands. Ah, okay, excellent. So we'll get that finished up. These folks are some Marines that landed, now don't have anything to do. Well, Marines, you are going to become a standardized infantry group. Experience be damned. And you're going to join probably the U.S. front over here. I think that's going to be okay. All right, no one doesn't have an army. Well, that new guy doesn't. Tell you what, you can join that. That's going to be fine. And everyone else should mostly be active. Okay, how's the Soviets? Good, that's all been resolved. And y'all do still have... That's actually a pretty weak sauce battle plan. Let's see here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a handful of these, put them into a new army. I'm going to trim off 1, 2, 3, and just put them into, I don't know, over there. What is this? Group of two. Oh, it's that. I'm going to move you to be considered part of the home guard. Cancel all your orders and just put you on garrison area up there and there. Hold that. Okay. That's going to be fine. Now, this group here, which I'm going to recolor to red, let's say, because we had way too many things that are purple. You could also use some sort of general. So we're going to do that. I'm going to assign you to this front line with a command to finish this off. I mean, I really don't need this many people, but that's going to be fine. So you go. Meanwhile, purple over here, no, you're going to join that purple. Teal, you're wrapping this up, which is great. I'm going to put you on aggressive mode. This purple, we're going to recolor you to say green. You don't have an offensive line. Oh, I don't think you do. Stop. That was a misclick. Don't do that. Just push out something like that. And then finally, purple over here. I'm going to cancel all your orders and draw you a front line over here. There we go. And an offensive line that just push in. Just push in some way. And go. That's going to be fine. All right, I think that's going to be an improvement. A little bit more focused is going to be good. I mean, really, red group, there's not a whole lot to do, and I could probably just have, like, one guy take care of all this for me with a little bit of manual driving around. We'll autosave. Oh my god, the Soviet Union has capitulated. So, when I was seeing, you know, the chopped up territory over here, I assumed, actually, the Soviet Union was pushing in quite far, but in fact, Finland! A push from Finland makes the run for... That's Perm. How come I can't see the victory points very well? I just want to find Moscow. There it is. Wow. Okay, that'll change things up considerably. What the shit? Because now... There's definitely the UK are still pushing forward east over here. But Germany and Italy are going to be able to dedicate all their troops there. Although Italy is likely to be on the verge of capitulation over here, which is double plus on good. So let's change something. We're going to call this, I guess we'll call this the Western Front. This is us trying to help Italy and Germany hold. So you guys are going to cancel all your orders. Then I'm going to give you a front line. How come I can't draw a front line there? I can't enter? Is Italy... You're in the Axis. We're in the same war together, are we not? I'm an idiot. I'm not in the Axis. I've got my own faction. That's right. That's right. Oh, okay. I forgot I'm not in the Axis. We really did go ahistorical here. It's a little bit annoying because we're not going to get... Well, I guess we wouldn't have gotten much out of this peace conference regardless. That's what I'm so confused about from last time. Aha! Alright, that's fine. Okay, green, I'm going to delete your offensive line, since obviously we're not going to Soviet territory anymore. And instead, you're just going to march through something like that. Purple, you really don't have a lot going on unless we're going to declare war against the Axis, but that's not what I'm planning on doing at this time. So I'm going to cancel that. I'll set you a new front line that is just on the German front. But then I'm going to take like half of you guys, and I'm going to make a new army that's going to be added to the so-called Canadian invasion force, which is not really all about Canada, but that's all right. Let's pretend. And I'm going to give you a general. And I'm going to tell you, I'm just going to give you a garrison area for now, which will help you just move over here. And then we'll assign you to some actual commands at that point. So the Western Front, we don't have a real Western Front to take care of. Let's take a look at our diplomacy map mode here, so we can quickly see everything we're at war with. So I could get open borders with Italy, although I can't attack from there. But hitting Africa might be fun. But really, I think what we have to do is we have to focus on who we can cause to break on the other side. Which ain't going to be easy. At all. What is this? You. Go and take that. Netherlands still consider that to be theirs? I don't approve. What do we have going on over here? Are you doing your naval invasion? How come you're not going? Because your battle plan is active. So should you not be crossing over to here? I'm going to reset yours, because I'm pretty sure that was we set that up 100 years ago and it didn't go yet. We're going to do that. And then just get you to expand out afterwards. That's going to be fine. Get your 6 convoys, that's going to be okay. So we have Australia. So really, there's nothing other than a couple little blips over here in Manila where we don't actually have anyone. So tell you what, Western Front, here's what your job is going to be. Your job is going to be to come over. Well, we've got all the actual ports, so we'd just be filling in a few gaps. Still, go ahead and I'm just going to assign some garrison area. They will go and retake those zones. They won't really fight for it, but they will go and just fill in those gaps. So I'm going to do this for now, and then we'll sort you out afterwards. That's going to be okay. Australian defense, that's all right. So in Iran, we might want to do something like declare war on Oman over here, for example. Which I kind of like the idea of. We'll have to get a bit of a troop. So green is busy. Blue is busy. Once we clear some of this up, we're going to go and declare on Oman using one of those armies, because I don't want to leave there. Fall of Moscow. Hey, excellent. We can do a treaty. We actually have... Okay, no. Germany went first, and they took a crap ton of stuff, which is expected. So what do we want? Probably more stuff over here. This seems like a kind of a no-brainer. We want these states. Maybe over here, you know, makes that a lot nicer. Actually, is this... That's a line. Says it go up to a river or something like that? That's a good start. We definitely want control over that. I think we probably want to grab this stuff. We could just puppet these guys. But no, we'll go ahead and do that. Probably not much in the way of factories and resources, but we'll give it a go. And it's probably good. We're going to take everything along the coast here. So the islands are gone as well. Oh, we can't. Really? That was too much. We may have to leave you then. Because while there's not a lot of value here, it seems like the sort of thing we might want to control. Like that. Yeah, you are really expensive. I mean, I could just save a few points. So that's okay. But this puts us over the edge. So we'll take Mongolia. And I'm assuming, yeah, that's pretty much all we can do right now. Because it'll put us too far below the next actor. All right, I like that. End turn. Now, only 180 points. Oh. No, no, I was misreading something. Oh, 80 is what we'd get if we passed. So we're going to take that, which is good. And then I think what I would do is I would like to expand out over here. Ooh, that's too much. That's all too much. I'm wondering if I should prioritize that for the oil. Now, I want this just because it's going to make our borders look a lot better. I'm going to do this. I'm going to hope we can get some coxes. Excellent. There. There. Okay. All right, that's the limit there. It's still probably a good grab. Can I grab that? No. We're really, really at our border here. At our limit. Now where do we want to go? Well, I guess we'll go ahead and grab this for access to the Black Sea. That's probably a really good idea. Let's take Georgia. That is the Black Sea, right? I think so. All right, that I like. And then probably I just keep pushing in from over here. On the other hand, take these mountains, good defensive location. Maybe the airfield over here. Oh, that's too much. I should probably just pass and get a whole bunch more points for the next round. So I can take a more contiguous thing. Because you get bonus points if you pass. I'm going to pass. It'll give Germany a chance to take some more stuff, but probably not a whole lot. There we go. Now we've got more points. I think they may have passed as well. And I can grab that airfield. Okay, then what we're going to do is push in from the east. This stuff is all really cheap, but it'll make our name bigger. Could do another pass. And turn. Okay, we really can't grab much, so I'm going to just take the extra 80 points here. And just try to grab as much contiguous land as possible. I'm wondering about doing one more pass for the bonus points. Yeah, I will do that. I mean, they might nibble a little, but there we go. Now we've got lots of extra points. It'd be nice if we could wrap around here. I guess if I deselected that, there we go. Oh, that's 51 points versus 1 point. 51? There's a lot of stuff going on over there. Let's do this. They probably won't grab that because it's not contiguous. There we go. And then on my turn. Oh, I still can't grab it. Pass. And then grab that. Good. And then some more cheap territory over here. If I did this, I have access to the sea in the north, which is kind of nifty. There's a lot left, and I'm wondering about doing another skip. Although, yeah, see, these don't all connect, but what a fun little grab for some potential later on. Although, this will be a little harder to defend, since getting troops to there is quite hard, and this does give a place for the UK to land on us. On the other hand, it gives us somewhere to launch our own invasions from. Right? Because I can launch from here. It's quite far. I think we're at war with Norway, or Denmark, or something, although they might all be. This shows sort of original borders. It's not necessarily helping us know what they're how they're controlled right now. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and grab that. But then I will go back to nibbling on this stuff. Grab the 3? No, I can't even grab the 3. What about the 1? Really? I'm right at that limit. Okay. I'm going to do another skip here. So I can actually take meaningful land. Aww. Oh, I can't grab the 1. But I can grab these, and they're fairly valuable, so I think I'm going to go for it. On the other hand, there's some really valuable territory over here. I mean, then it costs more. No, I'm going to go ahead and grab that. Oh, and then we just have a little exclave over there. That would be kind of awkward. Let me... I really can't grab anything. I'll just pass then. And probably keep passing. I could take this. Because that's really not appealing. So you know what? Let's grab that. And then I think I'm done. We'll let, you know, whoever grabbed that at some point. That's going to be okay. Well, I don't know. I'll start passing and see if we end up with enough points to pick that up. I guess we're going to do that. We'll have a little pocket of territory in there. All right. Fair enough. Done. Peace conference is over! I can't believe I thought I was in the Axis. I forgot about that. All right. We took 44 states. Not as much as the German Reich. But we did take a hell of a lot. We have exiled divisions. That's fine. We're going to put a cut in here. I'm going to have to figure out, like, all my stuff. Where are the exiled divisions? Oh, pause. Right, because some of this territory over here, this is Italian now. So, did we get the oil? I wasn't actually looking at the resources map mode, and I could have rushed it. Oh, yeah, we got the 126 oil over here, which is fan-frickin-tastic. We have a surplus now. So we can cancel that. Surplus of aluminum. Big surplus of steel. We don't have to import anything right now. Production rates should go up. I didn't take a look at my construction factories before and after, although I think we may have grabbed another 40 or 50 civilian factories here, which is a pretty noticeable amount. We're gonna have to cancel a lot of our battle orders, and we are still at war with people, but, you know, so I'm happy I jumped into the war against the Soviets, and apparently we did a good amount of damage to them, which is pretty substantial. I could go and see about finishing off a few. These guys are fascist, though. Oh, these guys are part of me. Over here, you guys are part of the Axis. Yeah, I don't think our plans involve declaring war on the Axis right now. We're almost certainly going to want to finish our first war first. First war first? Yeah, sure. Which is to say, deploying more troops over here. I do think deploying troops into Africa would actually be pretty good for us as a way to punch back against the Allies. Cut them off from certain types of resources as well. Pretty easy land to grab with the right kind of troops. We'll see what we can do. But we are going to have to wrap this up now. We are almost at our cap for army experience, but we are going to do some shuffling of our divisions relatively soon. That's part of what is the logistics company and field hospitals. That's what they're for. Anyway, thank you very much for watching another episode, folks, and I'll see you guys next time.